Hello and welcome back to the Linux Panic YouTube channel. In this video I'm going to be showing you how to install Wine 7.0 or greater on any Manjaro based Linux or its derivatives. But first, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button so you don't miss out on any future videos. So, I would like to thank the viewer, Zaid, who commented on an older video of mine entitled How to Install Wine 7.3 in Manjaro Linux. It is because of him that I have found out that the way you also install Wine on Manjaro-based systems, or Arch-based, isn't what it used to be. So when Wine HQ changed how you install Wine on Ubuntu, or Debian-based variations, or Fedora, for example, they also changed how you do it for everything. So because of that, I'm making this video here to show you how to do it. So you're probably wondering, why Wine on an Arch-based one? It's Arch. You're not supposed to do that. It's your operating system. You've installed it. You do whatever the hell you want with it. I don't care. I'm just here to help. So I'd like to thank Zaid. I'll pop the comment up on screen now, just to show it off, and then we'll go through. So first thing we want to do is we want to update our system. As we can see here, I'm just logged in, so we're just going to do a quick update run. We're going to do sudo pacman-syu. Give it the password, which in this case is just Manjaro. This VM's going to be killed off anyway when I'm done. As we can see here, there's nothing left to up, and there's nothing to update because I have already done so. And as we can see here, we're running on kernel 5.15. Uptime's been 5 minutes because that's how long it's been turned on. Those are the packages, you know, the usual stuff. So first thing we're going to do after updating is we're going to install the various packages we need. Now I'm going to do these one at a time and just go through them, but I've also made an install script which I will show you in my GitHub once we're done here. So first thing we need to do is we need to install Wine itself with sudo pacman-swine. So what this is going to do is it's going to get all the packages it needs. So in this case, it's going to download 73 megabytes worth of stuff. And as you can see here, it's mostly just fonts. Like all of this, except this package here. And this one here is just fonts and how to deal with things. Yeah, there's a couple of audio things, but majority of this is just fonts because of the wide range of fonts available on Windows. So you've got to account for that by providing an equal or alternative to a font package or set or what have you. Now, as you can see here, this is just 25 packages. It's no bother at all. This is downloading in real time. It works fine. As we can see here, this is running a bit slow. Now, this might be because of a network issue. Sometimes Manjaro will downgrade your speeds to your router. In my case, it's negotiating down to 100 megabytes when actuality it should be negotiated to 1 gig. So I'll just give that a quick fix and we'll just wait for this to finish off. So what this is doing is just getting the main like Wine packages. Now at this point you could do whatever you want with it, it will just work, but we're going to install a couple of extra packages at the same time just to make our life easier. We're going to install Wine Tricks, which is a interface to configure Wine. You can also use it to install some Windows software. It just comes with them as standard, such as Notepad++. If you're a user of that, or I don't know what else Wine Tricks come with, as I don't use Wine Tricks myself, but it is just a user interface of a graphical variety, so you can actually see what you're doing instead of going, well, I need this package, I need that package, and just installing it through the terminal. It's easier to use, as some people would say. In my usage of it, I didn't really find it easy. I just got the exe I wanted to use and just installed and said, please work. It's just, that's what I preferred to do. So now we're done here. It's just going to go through and check the integrity of everything. It's going to do some font configuration, as we can see here. This will take barely any time at all. And as we can see now, it's installing Wine. It's gone through everything and that is installed. So next we're going to install Wine Tricks. So it's just hit up and then do Wine Tricks. Yes, tell it to install. It's just that fast. No bothers at all. It took literally seconds. It took longer to download that. I'm not going to try and butcher saying that one. And now we want to do wine mono. This is just to get this to work with mono based packages. So for the implementation of .NET framework for software, anything that runs on the .NET framework needs wine mono. So this is why we get this at the same time. Now, a lot of software has some form of integration with .NET framework, so it is a mandatory requirement of running Wine. Now, if you run Wine without having installed Wine Mono, it'll say, hey, look, I don't have the Mono package. Can I have that? And you just click yes and it'll download it. It's nothing. It's no bothers at all. One of the things I do like is how small the download size is compared to the install size. So you're not wasting time just downloading. As we can see here, I'm wasting time downloading because apparently Manjaro doesn't like... Oh, there we go. As I'm saying, hey, look, it doesn't like that I've told that I've kicked it in the ass and told it what the negotiation speed is. It's just up and down. Can't make up its mind. But that's fine. Now, you don't have to go through the manual process of this. I have actually made two scripts already that will be made available by the time you see this video in both a releases form and on the main repository itself. So it's just you can then choose to run the scripts if you fancy it. Of course, you can have a look at the scripts beforehand just to make sure it's fine. This is your right to do so. It's you can choose whatever you want to do. So once that's done, we then install Wine Gecko, which is the implementation of If Internet Explorer is used in any software, this will allow that to run without any hassle. As we can see here, that's also a bit bigger than the Wine Mono package, but this should also download just as fast without any hassle. I say that, it can't make up its mind whether it's 53 seconds or 4 minutes, but that's fine, we just let it be. We can see it in real time, it's no bother. So while this works, I am going to go get Windows executable, for example. In this case, we're going to go download a Google Chrome installer. Now, that's a bit of a hassle to try and find that, so we want a Google Chrome download. Now, I'm going to do the dangerous thing of not go to Chrome, well, not go to Google, because trying to download an exe from Google when you're not on the intended operating system can be a bit of a pain because Google likes to squirrel things away for some reason. But that's Google. I don't know where they do that. So once this should start downloading. If not, we just give the old kick in the face. And there we go. Launch from external download is started, which is here we want it. Just going to go through the process of, hey, look, work. As we can see here, it's finished downloading. It took faster to download that than it did the package. This is because of the package mirror, not because of Google. So this does take a bit of time. As you can see there, it just spikes up and down. That is just based off the package mirror. That's all it is. Now, Google Chrome will always download fast from Google because it's Google. They're hooked up to they're basically just hooked directly into the internet from any of their servers. They just will work straight away. Anytime you make a request to Google, it's just instant hello. Remember, hydrate whilst doing this. This could take some time, it could not. It just depends on how close you are to a mirror. So whilst we just wait for this, in my testing earlier on, it didn't take this long. But that's just karmic justice. The second I start recording, it then takes an age instead, as it does. So I have to fill the gap, which I would say I've done rather successfully. And as we can see here, it is now finished downloading. So what it's going to do is just going to check everything's fine here and we're off to the races. Now, if you wanted to, you could have done that all with one command. So just run all the packages with a space. But I didn't. So here we are. Now we need to check what version of Wine we have installed. And as we can see here, we have installed Wine 7.11. This is the latest stable version of Wine available. Wine, I would have you believe that the latest stable version is Wine 7.0, when in actual fact it's not. They are currently working on development version Wine 7.12, But clearly, this is not the development version, because the development version would be Wine staging. But as we installed the stable version, we actually have Wine 7.11. So now that we've downloaded our executable, let's try and give it a run. We will come to the downloads. As we can see here, this recognizes it as an exe. For the first time we run an exe, we need to right click and open with Windows Wine Program Loader. So this will just get your system into the habit of going, hey, look, this is an exe. I should run it with a Wine Loader. It doesn't do that by default. If you try and open it by default, all it's just going to do is go, I don't know what's going on, and then try and open it as a compressed file, which you don't want it to do, but that's fine. So as we can see here, it's just going through the normal Chrome install process. If this wasn't Manjaro, you wouldn't be able to tell the difference between this and a regular old installer, regular old Google Chrome installer. So this is just going through the motions. Whilst it does that, we will open WineTricks. As we can see here, once it loads, I'm using the 32-bit version, I know. I wish to carry on using the 32-bit version. Let's install an application. So click OK, and oh, I don't know. Let's choose MS Paint. Click OK. Click yes. And as we can see here, Google Chrome's finished installing. I know I chose that one. Yeah, okay, that's fine. Just work around that. Yes, I know I'm using a 64-bit version. This will just go through the process. And for some reason, this is in German. So yeah, I want the software package. Hello to people from Germany. And we are done. What would I like to do this with this Wine prefix? Nothing. And now if we just go, if we now empty this, we should have had MS Paint. But in this case, it's fine. It's just, this is why I don't like using WineTricks. You tell it to do something and it doesn't do it some of the time. This is why I just prefer installing what I want to install and get it to run without any bother. So as we can see here, it's saying it's been installed, but I don't believe that. So that's why I don't use it. So as we can see here, if this will go away, we have installed Google Chrome. And we're going to open it. Now you're probably wondering, what is this black screen here? Because this is an older version of Chrome. Now I'm talking 2014 levels of old Chrome. Things are a bit funky. This is like Windows 7, like levels, Windows 7, early Windows 8 levels of Google Chrome. This is how old it is, because trying to get a hold of an updated version can be a bit of a pain in the ass. But it works. This is currently working. It does have a bit of funky fonts. That is the disadvantage of not running it on Windows. We've had to install an alternative font package, so this is why it's different. So why don't we go to my GitHub? So we'll go to my GitHub. Now this will work just the same as anywhere else. This may take a bit longer. You telling me GitHub's not secure? I somehow don't believe that. So for some reason, GitHub is having an issue where it thinks it's unsecure. Well, Google Chrome thinks GitHub is insecure, which is strange. Strange to say the least. So we'll just run it through here. So this is where I have installed I've uploaded the install package. As you can see here, it's running fine. Yes, my ugly mug there, I know. Broke a mirror, I know. As we can see here, we have the Wine 7 staging install for Manjaro and Wine 7 install for Manjaro. uploaded 21 minutes ago. That's how long it took me. Well, this, I wanted to make sure it's prepared before doing this. I have tested them. They do work and they have the correct encoding. They will be set up as a release before this video is uploaded, before this video is made available to you guys. But yeah, this is how to install an updated version of Wine on Arch-based operating systems. Now, I did say this is Manjaro. However, this is based off Arch, and it should work with Arch. Anyway, I'd like to thank you very much for watching. If you're not already subscribed, maybe consider clicking that subscribe button and giving that notification bell a good old ring, because I've been informed by various people that even though they are subscribed and have the rung the notification bell, YouTube is not sending out notifications. It's annoying. I'd like to say hello to the students of the University of New South Wales in Australia. Hello, I hope you're enjoying the videos. If you watch from there, just say hi in the comments. I'd love to be able to reach out and help you with any questions you have. I hope you're doing well over there. I hope you're doing well in the floods as well. Anyway, I'd like to thank you very much for watching. I have been Nick. You have been amazing. And I hope you have a good rest of your day. Goodbye.